Hey, Sylvia Perez here. Welcome to this video. In this video, I'm going to talk about Google Ads naming conventions and how to go ahead and name your Google Ads campaigns. Now, this topic for this video isn't something that's very popular or, you know, very sexy or anything like that. This is a very boring and almost seems meaningless to talk about, but actually naming your campaigns correctly is a huge deal, because as you start to create more campaigns, if you don't have a system in place on how to go about naming your campaigns, it can get real messy real quick. And even if you, let's say you're doing your Google Ads yourself and you're the one creating all your campaigns and you understand how you have things, that's great. But if you ever decide later on down the line that you want to bring in some help, or you want to hire an employee to do this for you or anything, or just involve any other human being within your Google Ads account, if you don't have a process in place on how to go about naming those campaigns, it's going to be a real nightmare. And even if it's just you doing your campaigns yourself, if you don't have a process in place when it comes to reporting on your campaigns, that's going to be a real nightmare too. So I want to go ahead and get into this video, and I want to cover three main points on naming your campaigns and what I found to work best in my experience. So let's get started. So looking right here in the Google Ads interface, you can see I have three campaigns. One is furniture, the other one's Colorado, and then the other one is campaign number one. So most of the times when I review Google Ads accounts, I notice the name of the campaign that the account I'm reviewing is either in one of these three buckets. So most people, they either name their campaign based on like the Google default setting, which is by a number. So campaign number one, number two, number three, number four, so on and so forth. That's usually one of the most common ones, because people create the campaigns and they just leave the Google default name. The other one that I usually see is they'll name their campaigns by location. So they'll say, for example, just Colorado if they're running ads in Colorado. And then the last one is they'll do it by whichever product they're offering. So they'll do furniture. Now, I think of all these three, if you had to go with one, I would say, you know, furniture is probably the best, because at least has some indication on what kind of campaign you're running. But just naming your campaign furniture based on the product or service you're selling isn't enough. You want to go ahead and make sure that you're adding more information. Now, I want to get into my first point. First point I want to make is whatever you decide, it's personal. However you're going to go about naming your campaigns, make sure that first and foremost, you have a process in place. This is the most important thing. So for example, if you decide for you and your business and your reasons and whatever it might be, that all your campaigns, you're just going to name them based on the product or the service you're offering, so in this case, furniture, then cool, by all means, go ahead. And if you find that works best for you, then you know, feel free to do that. That's the first thing, is make sure you have a process in place. And I'm going to go over an example of, you know, how I like to name my campaigns and kind of why I do it this way. And it might not be the best way, but it's what's worked for me. And then the second thing I want to talk about is whatever it is you decide on how you're going to name your campaigns, please make sure that it is easy to understand. Because again, going back, if you ever decide to involve another person into your account management, you want to make sure that your campaigns are named in a way that it's easy to explain, because you have that process and it's easy to understand, so that when they go into your account, they're not just seeing campaign number one, two, three, and four, and five, and so on and so forth, and then they have to click into the campaign and go down to the keyword level to actually understand what it is you're selling, where you're selling it, what devices you're selling it on, so on and so forth. So just make sure that it's easy to understand. And then last but not least, the third point, so kind of recap, first point was to have a system, have a process. Second point is make it easy to understand. And then the last point is make sure that you set it up in a way that it does not hurt your reporting, that it doesn't make your life harder. So I want to go ahead and show you an example of what I mean by that. So for example, let's go ahead and download this campaign report, and we're going to go ahead and see what this is like when we want to go ahead and report on this. If we're using Excel, if you're using GA, you know, it can be a very similar thing if you're searching within GA. But let's just go ahead and use Excel for this example. So I'm going to go ahead and open up this Excel doc, and I'm going to show you guys. So for example, you know, this is a very small account too, by the way, so definitely it'll be a lot easier to filter through these campaigns. But imagine when you know, try to think bigger, right? Like when your account is growing and now you're not just using search campaigns, you're using display campaigns and you're using video campaigns, but not just these type of campaigns, you're reaching people in different stages of the funnel. So how are you gonna segment the different types of campaigns you're using? Maybe you're reaching top of the funnel traffic. Maybe it's more of an awareness campaign. Maybe it's more bottom of the funnel. It's more, you know, direct response, trying to get the sale. So how do you go about differentiating all these things within your campaign name? These are all things to consider when you put together that process for yourself. So for example, I'm gonna go ahead and just kind of clean this report up a little bit. And we're just gonna, you know, really show you what I mean by this. So just, you know, at the very basic, let's say we have a whole bunch of campaigns, right? We only have these two campaigns, but at the very minimum, let's say we want to filter by campaign type. So we want to filter between search campaigns and display campaigns. If I just download this campaign report and I don't have the campaign type column already enabled, it's going to be really hard for me to filter by this, right? So that means I'm going to have to click on this drop-down arrow and then I'm going to have to filter by campaign type. But what if our campaigns are more complex and it's not just about, you know, search or display or this and that, maybe it's a certain stage of the funnel, then how are we gonna go and segment that? So by putting those things in your campaign name, all we have to do is just click on this campaign column. We can unselect this and we can search, for example, you know, maybe we're reaching top of the funnel traffic with a certain campaign. So we'll name them tofu for top funnel. And we just go ahead and search that. And then it's going to filter all those campaigns that are top of the funnel campaigns. Or maybe we're targeting campaigns that are selling furniture in Colorado, for example. So then we can put furniture and Colorado and go ahead and pull that out. So naming your campaigns has a huge effect on your campaign reporting. So just something to keep in mind. Now I want to go ahead and kind of go backwards a little bit and go back into the Google Ads interface and just kind of show you some examples of how you can go about naming your campaigns. And this is kind of how I've been going about doing it. And I would love to hear if you guys have another way. So kind of the way I would go about doing this, let's say I'm doing a furniture campaign. It's a search campaign and it's in Colorado. So the way I would like to do it is usually I like to start with the business name. So I'll go ahead and let's call this business, I don't know, let's call them Furniture Miami. That's their name. All right, so then what I would do is I would start with the business name. Then from there, I would put the campaign type. So for example, there are a lot of different types of campaigns you can create, right? Going back to the previous example, it can be an awareness campaign. It can be a brand campaign. So it can be a conquest campaign. Maybe this campaign is meant to go against competitors and bid on competitor keywords. So whatever that campaign type is, I'll go ahead and put that in this section, right? And I usually like to put the little, I don't even know what you call that, like the pipe symbol to separate the different names. So we have the business name and then we have the campaign type. So let's just say this is a brand campaign. So we're doing branded keywords. And then from there, this is on the search network. So I'll go ahead and put in search. And then from there, I'll go ahead and put in the location here. So if this is a local business, or even if it's international business, I like to go ahead and put in the locations here. That way I can further segment this type of campaign. So then let's just say Colorado. And then last but not least, I'll put all devices, and that's kind of how I'll wrap it out. And then usually if I like to get more granular, what you can do as well is before all devices, I like to put like the stage of the funnel that this campaign is. So let's just say we're doing bottom of the funnel. So I like to go BOFU and then space and then all devices, and I'll save that. And now our campaign is saved, and we don't only know that this campaign is a brand campaign, we know that it's a search campaign, we know that it's showing ads in Colorado, and we know that we're reaching people on the bottom of the funnel, and we're targeting all devices. So now with this campaign naming structure, we can get a lot more granular, we can have much better understanding of what's going on and what purpose this campaign serves, and that way when we go to report, we can easily filter to find this campaign and other campaigns like it. So that is it for this video. So to recap, make sure you have a process in place. Whatever it is for you, there's no right or wrong way, as long as it works for you. Second, that it's easy to understand. And third, that it does not hurt you when it comes to reporting. So those are the three major points. And also another tip too, to also consider when writing your naming process, is some people like to separate campaigns by match type. So maybe you filter your campaign names by the match type. Other people like to also put in the languages. So if this is an English campaign versus a Spanish campaign. Other people as well make specific campaigns for specific types of products. So you might want to put in those products within the campaign name as well. So there's all other things that you can consider when putting together your process. And your process will evolve with you as you adapt, as you learn, as your account grows, and so on and so forth. But that is it for this video, guys. I had a bit of a cold, so if you hear my voice a lot deeper, I apologize for that, but I wanted to shoot this video for you. So that is it. Go ahead and follow along and subscribe to the channel if you got some value from this video, and I'll see you next time. Take care.